Hello, today's video is about load switches. You may not have heard the term load switch very often, so let's start with a simple question. What is a load switch? While it might not be the most noticeable component in a circuit, it plays a critical role in managing power delivery. Load switches are used to safely and efficiently switch power lines on off, particularly in high power applications like USB chargers and power banks. A key component in any load switch is the MOSFET, and ROM has just launched an exciting new product, so let's use that to help explain how load switches work. Here's the new MOSFET. It's quite small, maybe too small to see clearly at first glance. This is ROM's ultra-compact, ultra-low on resistance dual N-channel MOSFET. Despite its tiny size, its specs make it ideal for load switch applications, supporting high-efficiency, space-saving circuit designs. In this video, we'll cover the role, types, and operating principles of load switches, while highlighting how ROM's latest product excels in these applications. The primary role of a load switch is to control power supply to a circuit. When we say switch, we're not referring to mechanical ones like this, but rather to electronic switches embedded within circuits, like the one shown here. That said, both serve the same essential purpose. For example, in a power bank, the load switch is placed in this section of the circuit. First are the USB input-output ports, then load switch, followed by the battery and charging control circuitry. By turning the load switch on/off, you can control the connection between external devices and internal circuitry of the power bank. When paired with a load switch controller, you can implement additional features such as overvoltage and overcurrent protection, reverse current prevention, and power saving functionality by opening the switch to completely cut off power when not needed. There are many ways to configure a load switch circuit, but today we'll focus on a few examples. Here's one of the simplest configurations. On the left, we have a P-channel MOSFET setup, and on the right, a configuration using an N-channel MOSFET. Let's begin by looking at how the P-channel circuit works. With a P-channel MOSFET, current flows when the gate voltage is lower than the source voltage. So when this switch is closed, current flows through the circuit like this. One of the advantages of this setup is that the drive circuitry remains relatively simple. Although we're showing a mechanical switch for clarity, in practice, an N-channel MOSFET is often used instead. Next, in the case of an N-channel MOSFET, current begins to flow when the gate voltage exceeds the source voltage. Here is an example to illustrate the operation. If you set this point to 5 volts, current will begin to flow, and it flows in this direction. To stop the current with a P-channel MOSFET, you simply open this point, and in the case of an N-channel MOSFET, you short this point to 0 volt. This allows you to turn the power supply to the load on/off as needed. Another key function of load switches is preventing reverse current flow. Let's examine what happens in this circuit scenario. To understand reverse current, remember that current naturally flows from higher to lower voltage. So if for any reason the load voltage becomes higher than the power supply voltage, there's a risk that current may flow in the reverse direction. In this setup, the load is currently a resistor, but in real-world applications, it could also be a battery, so to simulate that scenario, we swap the positions of the power supply and load. As a result, current now flows in the reverse direction, just like this. This happens because the current passes through the MOSFET's body diode. This side also contains a body diode shown here. We intentionally left it out earlier. Since this configuration allows current to flow in only one direction, it's known as a unidirectional load switch. However, with proper circuit design, reverse current can be effectively blocked. For those familiar with electronics, the term reverse current may ring a bell. That's right. One simple solution is to add a diode. The diode can be placed on either the source or drain side. Both configurations are acceptable. The same principle applies to N-channel MOSFETs. As shown here, the diode can be connected to either the drain or source side. Both are valid options. By adding the diode, reverse current is blocked and prevented from flowing. If you switch the power supply and load back to their original positions, current will flow normally again. However, this method introduces a forward drop across the diode, typically around 0.7 volts. As a result, the voltage at the load decreases by about 0.7 volts. To maintain the required voltage at the load, the power supply voltage must be increased slightly, which can be quite a hassle. Also, when current flows to the load, it also passes through the diode, leading to power loss. This loss is calculated as forward voltage multiplied by current. If the current is small, it's not a big issue, but when handling large currents, say 10 amps, the diode can incur a power loss of 7 watts. This can cause it to heat up significantly. When integrating a load switch into compact devices, the heat generated becomes too significant to overlook. To further optimize the circuit and eliminate power loss caused by the diode, a common approach is to connect a MOSFET in reverse orientation. The goal is to ensure that current flows mainly through the MOSFET. By doing this, you can control current flow in both directions while also preventing reverse current, resulting in a load switch with even lower power loss. This type of configuration is known as a bidirectional load switch. The circuit is designed so that the MOSFET's body diode is reverse connected, which means that when the MOSFET is turned off, the diode naturally blocks any unwanted current flow. It's a clever and well-engineered solution. Incidentally, power loss in a MOSFET is proportional to the square of the current multiplied by its own resistance. This on resistance refers to the inherent resistance within the MOSFET when it is turned on. For MOSFETs used in load switch applications, on resistance typically ranges from a few milliohms to several tens of milliohms. Depending on the current level, MOSFETs often exhibit lower power loss than diodes. The typical power loss profile looks like this. Up to a certain point, routing current through the MOSFET is more efficient. The next design decision is whether to use a P-channel or N-channel MOSFET. One benefit of using a P-channel MOSFET is that it generally doesn't require a dedicated gate drive power supply. This helps simplify overall circuit design. However, there is one notable drawback, and it can be quite significant. The on-resistance of a P-channel MOSFET is generally higher than that of an N-channel MOSFET, which leads to greater power loss during operation. This becomes especially important in load switch applications where the MOSFET is used purely as a switch and minimizing power loss is critical. Additionally, load switches typically require low on-resistance, high-current MOSFETs, but such P-channel options are relatively limited in the market. As a result, using P-channel MOSFETs in high-current load switch designs can be challenging. Next, let's look at using an N-channel MOSFET as a load switch. The main advantage of N-channel MOSFETs is their superior overall performance compared to P-channel types. Most notably, they offer lower on-resistance. They're also much more widely available, with a broader range of options than P-channel MOSFETs. However, a key drawback is the need for an additional power supply to drive the MOSFET. To turn on an N-channel MOSFET, the gate voltage must be higher than the source voltage, meaning you need a voltage that exceeds the circuit's own operating voltage. This can be resolved using a dedicated driver IC, but it comes at the cost of increased component count and PCB area. Additionally, whether using P-channel or N-channel, two MOSFETs are normally required, which doubles the component footprint, making miniaturization more difficult. Product planners, procurement specialists, and circuit designers are constantly tasked with finding low on resistance MOSFETs while also keeping the footprint as small as possible. That's where ROHM silicon N-channel MOSFETs, purpose-built for load switch applications, come into play. This article introduces the new MOSFET, featuring an ultra-compact 2mm square wafer-level chip size package. Unlike most MOSFETs that are typically molded in black epoxy resin, this one uses a wafer-level package to minimize footprint area. Looking at the backside, you can see the bare silicon chip. For more details, the product link is available in the video description. Here's a look at the internal structure. There are two MOSFETs integrated into a single package, which helps reduce board space. But that's not all. Another key feature is it's exceptionally low on resistance of just 2 milliohms. The resistance between these two points is 2 milliohms. It supports a continuous current of plus minus 20 amps, which is quite substantial. And in pulse mode, it can handle up to 40 amps. ROHM claims to offer the industry's lowest on resistance, which helps to minimize heat generation and allows for a more compact package. In addition, the absence of a lead frame enables direct heat dissipation from the chip to the PCB, further improving thermal performance. A withstand voltage of 30 volts makes it well suited for 20 volt class applications. This provides ample margin for use in cases such as USB chargers operating at 20 volts 5 amps. A notable competitor in this space is a 40 volt rated bidirectional load switch utilizing gallium nitride. While GaN offers superior material characteristics and a higher voltage rating, ROHM's silicon-based MOSFET achieves lower on resistance, demonstrating exceptional performance despite the material difference. This level of semiconductor design and manufacturing expertise is a clear reflection of ROHM's well-established technical capabilities. Ideally, I would have preferred a higher rating to support 28-volt USB PD charging applications as well. This is coming from the perspective of someone who has taken apart numerous USB chargers. The reason is that USB chargers supporting 28 volts output often fall into a higher price bracket, which could have broadened the adoption potential for ROHM's new product in that segment. That said, achieving 40 volts withstand using silicon is no easy task. Now, let's take a look at the actual hardware in use. I mounted it on an evaluation board like this, and also put together a drive circuit to go with it. The driver IC I used is a load switch driver from Toshiba. The load switch itself is tiny, and the driver IC is just as compact. I assume that's intentional, given these are typically used in space-constrained environments. I used reflow soldering for assembly, but at this scale, it was definitely a challenge. Here is the test circuit. Feel free to pause here to take a closer look. A similar circuit is also included in the application note linked in the description. Now, let's begin the test.
Oh.
Everything looks good. The circuit is functioning as expected. The yellow waveform represents the control signal, while the red waveform indicates the current through the load switch. It's turning on and off correctly in sync with the control signal. No issues here. Next, I swap the power supply and load positions. As expected, current now flows in the reverse direction, and control is still working properly. This setup is also functioning without any problems. Next, let's verify whether the current is being properly interrupted. This yellow waveform is the output from the function generator, which serves as the input to the driver circuit. This time, we're measuring the delay, including the drive circuit. It seems there's a slight lag before the current begins to flow. When we zoom in to observe the moment the current is cut off, it looks like this. The MOSFET turns off in approximately 1.5 microseconds. Pretty good, right? The reason we're checking the shutoff speed is that the MOSFET is internally optimized for extremely low on resistance. There was some concern that this might result in slower switching, but it turned out not to be an issue. Next, let's look at heat generation. We applied 10 amps, which is half the rated current. While the heat dissipation area does seem a bit limited for 10 amps, we went ahead anyways. Using a thermal camera, we measured the temperature rise, which eventually reached 130 degrees Celsius. Overall, the temperature rise was higher than expected. For reference, we applied a blackbody sheet for thermal imaging, but the temperature readings were nearly identical with or without it. Incidentally, blackbody sheets are surprisingly expensive. This one cost around $40. To double check, we also measured the temperature using a thermocouple. It read approximately 110 degrees Celsius. However, the presence of the thermocouple affects heat dissipation, allowing some heat to escape. The MOSFET itself likely isn't the issue. The real variability comes from how well the ball grid array is soldered to the PCB. In fact, when we switched to the PCB on the right for soldering, the temperature dropped by about 10 degrees Celsius. This suggests that PCB layout and thermal design are critical for maximizing MOSFET performance. In terms of real-world applications, this MOSFET is well-suited for load switches in USB charging systems. It's also ideal for low-voltage, high-current environments such as battery protection circuits. Thanks to its compact footprint, it's a great choice for space-constrained designs requiring high-current capability. Have ideas for other potential applications? We'd love to hear them. Drop your thoughts in the comments. To wrap up today's discussion on load switches, while their primary role is to control power delivery through on-off switching with the right circuit design, they can also prevent reverse current flow. Moreover, when integrated with sensors, load switches can offer protection against overcurrent and overvoltage conditions. A link to ROM's N-channel MOSFET load switch featured in this video is available in the description, so be sure to check it out. If you found this video helpful, please like it and subscribe to our channel. And as always, feel free to leave any questions or comments below. Thanks for watching.